In this video, we'll see the recipe of creamy and delicious strawberry cheesecake, and it's a no-bake cheesecake. Let's get started. For this recipe, we need 12 biscuits, 12 digestive biscuits. So you can take digestive biscuits from any brand, but I suggest that you do not take Marie biscuits because the digestive ones go really well with this recipe and they are very tasty as a base of the cheesecake. So break them in a mixer grinder jar and grind to a powder. Here I've got 3 tablespoons butter, this is salted. Now I'm going to melt this in my microwave, but you can also use your regular gas stove to melt the butter. Now add the melted butter to the ground biscuits and mix it really well. For this recipe, you can use a mousse mold, a springform mold, or a mold like I'm using. It's a 6-inch cake mold, but the base comes off. And I'm placing a butter paper at the base so that it becomes easier for me to slice the cake. And I have lined the sides of this mold with acetate sheet, but you can line it with butter paper. Now evenly spread this mixture, so you can use your spoon or a katori or a glass to even it out, to level it. I am keeping this in my refrigerator till I prepare the cheesecake mixture. For this recipe, you need 200 gram cream cheese, so I just took it out of my refrigerator, not freezer. You need cream cheese and not any cheese or cheese spread for this, so you need to choose cream cheese. I saw that Delecta and Britannia has these small packages and I really like these because you cannot buy a 500 or 600 rupees big cream cheese pack because that's too expensive. So these small packages are good. Now add 2 tablespoons powdered sugar. And yes, this video is not sponsored by this brand of cream cheese or by Britannia. Okay, so give this a good stir so that the sugar and cream cheese is mixed well and this mixture is lump free. This is ready. And here I've got 1/4 cup cold whipping cream. I'm using non-dairy whipping cream and it's already sweetened. I know whipping cream is not accessible to many of you, but if you still want to make cheesecake, you can purchase it from Amazon because Amazon delivers in a lot of areas. And you can find Amazon storefront link in this video's description box where I have given all the products which I use or similar products, whichever I could find online, so you can check them out. So this cream is ready and to this whipped cream mixture I'm adding the cream cheese. Now after this we are not going to use the beater. The next step is to gently fold using a spatula. So just swirl and then cut and fold. You just need to fold it till the whipped cream and cheese are well combined. And yes, the cream cheese was cold, the whipping cream was cold, and now the whipped cream is cold. So this entire mixture is cold. And that's important. Now evenly spread this mixture in your cake tin. Now one thing I would like to tell you all, whoever has not eaten cream cheese directly. So this cream cheese is not very strong like your regular cheese spread or your regular cheese slices or processed cheese block. It has mild cheese taste. It is more creamy and rich. I'm putting it back in my fridge, not freezer, until we make the strawberry jam or sauce. So heat your kadhai or pan and add 200 gram chopped strawberries. These are roughly chopped. If you want, you can finely chop and then later strain if you want a smooth jam or smooth sauce. Now add 2 tablespoons sugar. Give this a good mix and keep the flame between low to medium, and you would see that gradually, because of the acids and the heat, the sugar would start to melt. Strawberries would leave the juices, and at the end you would get something like this. This sauce would thicken more as it cools down. So switch off your flame and let this delicious strawberry jam sauce, saucy jam, cool down. It's very important. Do not use hot or warm sauce on your cheesecake. Do not do that. And after it cools down, spread it evenly on your cheesecake. Now what you can do, you can first demold and then spread, or you can do it like I'm doing that. First spreading it and then I'm going to demold it. You may demold it right away, but I am again popping it in my refrigerator for 15 minutes. And it's time to demold the cheesecake. One tip, when you slice or cut this cheesecake, make sure you press the tip of the knife against the base and it would be easier for you to slice it easily, the biscuit base. So the biscuit base is not very hard, it's just that if you want clean cut, if you want to cut your slice nicely, then it's a bit tricky. The first slice was messy and this one, second one is better. Our creamy and delicious cheesecake at a very low price is ready. I wouldn't say it's a 10 rupees or 20 rupees cake, of course not, but definitely at much less cost compared to what you have to pay for single slice of cheesecake in the market. That too, you get them only in good or big bakeries or restaurants. Give this recipe a try and enjoy.